Hi class, Professor Dave here, and we're doing a second example for a hypothesis test for proportion. Suppose you heard that 60% of people exercise 3 hours or more. You sampled 400 people and 230 exercise more than 3 hours per week. Can we infer that less than 60% of people exercise more than 3 hours per week? And of course, we'll use the default significance level, alpha is equal to 0.05, or 95% confidence level. All right, so first we have to set up our hypotheses. Okay, and so the alternative is what we could possibly infer. So that's what we're gonna do first. So can we infer that less than 60%? All right, so clearly this is a proportion. And this is going to be less than 60%. Can we infer that there's less than 60% that exercise more than 3 hours per week? Okay, so the null hypothesis is the opposite of the alternative hypothesis and is the default conclusion. So the opposite of less than 60 is greater than or equal to 60, and I emphasize the equal part because that's we need to set. The null hypothesis is equal to something, that's kind of a rule, so that we can anchor our assumption so that we can calculate a p-value. All right, alpha is equal to 0.05, and again, the alternative is what we could possibly infer, so that's what we're looking to see if we can do. All right, first we have to check to see if our sample results allow us to possibly infer AJ. Now we have 230. For p hat, we have 230 out of 400, which is 56%, which is less than 60%, so we could possibly infer it. Now, if it was something like 72%, then we couldn't even possibly infer that it was less than 60% with our sample result. So we would stop right there. So since this is less than 60%, we're okay. Now, very important question is, why don't we automatically infer that the population is less than 60% based on this sample? And the very important understanding is that, well, sample results vary. And it is conceivable to get this sample result even if the null hypothesis is true. It could be within sampling chance. We have to see how unlikely this is. And if this is really unlikely under the assumption of the null hypothesis, then the null hypothesis is probably false, and we'll go and infer the alternative. Now, how unlikely does it have to be? Well, less than our willingness to make a type 1 error, less than alpha. And a type 1 error is wrongly rejecting a true null hypothesis. So, okay. So let's calculate our p-value. Well, our sample result was 230. And we want to find out the probability, the p-value is the probability of obtaining that sample result or more extreme. Okay, well that's less than 60%, and that's what we're trying to infer. So what's even more extreme, what's even more less than 60%? Well, even less account. So 230 or 229, 228, 227, that would be more extreme. So a p-value would be the probability of obtaining no people who exercise more than 3 hours a week, or one person out of the 400 or two, all the way up to 230. That would be our p-value. We add that all up. That's all the probabilities that are less than that sample result or more extreme. Well, either you exercise more than 3 hours a week or you don't. It's a binomial situation. So this is exactly a binomial cumulative distribution up to 230. So the way I show this is the exact probability. So we just add these all up, and we can do that with our calculator. And the parameters are, I like to say, NPR, National Public Radio. To remember, N is the number that we sample, P is the probability, the assumed probability under the null hypothesis, and R is the number of people that we actually obtained. So we do that, we put it on our calculator, and we get this. And let me just show that real quick on the calculator. Let's bring in a calculator. Okay, we turn it on. And we go to distributions, so second distributions. And we go down till we find binomial cumulative distribution. Enter. And then we just type in 400, and here's the comma, 0.6 comma 230. Close parenthesis, and we hit enter. Okay, and there's our probability, 0.166. Okay, so that's our p-value, probability of obtaining the same results or more extreme under the assumption of the null. That is not very unlikely, 16% chance, 17% chance. All right, it's not less than our willingness to make an error, which is rejecting a true null hypothesis. It's not less than 5%, so we do not reject HO. And that's basically the p-value method and the logic of it. Since the p-value is greater than alpha, do not reject HO and conclude there is not sufficient statistical evidence to infer that less than 60% of people exercise more than 3 hours per week. I hope you find that helpful.